Hello everyone. Today it is my pleasure to introduce the collaboration between AMD and Valve towards Steam Deck. My name is Sebastien Nussbaum. I'm Corporate Vice President of Products and Technologies in the Semi-Custom Business Unit at AMD. When Valve and AMD started discussing the silicon solution to use in Steam Deck, we focused on the performance versus power trade-off to enable an excellent gaming experience in a handheld form factor. The APU was designed from the ground up, optimized for consistent performance for extended period of time, running a variety of gaming workloads in the 4 to 15 watt range, which is a very different considerations and trade-offs in architecture, manufacturing process, and configuration compared to a typical notebook APU, which are usually more optimized for short durations boost and can be scaled up to about 45 watt operations. Even the package where the silicon is included is optimized to reduce the size by over 2/3 compared to a typical notebook PC package, and to optimize the thermal solution and the size of the system. Given the right feature and configuration was critical to the solution, this is where we spent the most time. The AMD custom APU in Steam Deck is also the first mobile APU to leverage the same RDNA 2 graphics found in our latest high-end PC and console graphics. The same RDNA 2 graphics feature set that is both DirectX 12 Ultimate capable, plus supporting the latest Vulkan feature set, including variable ray shading, ray tracing, and mesh shaders. For the memory subsystem, the AMD custom APU in Steam Deck is the first AMD processor to use LPDDR5 memory technology, providing both much higher memory bandwidth than DDR4 or LPDDR4, and also improves performance per watt further to enhance battery life. Throughout the development of Steam Deck, AMD and Valve worked together closely to tune hardware, firmware, and software. This collaboration helped to accelerate both game loading times and also boot times. A lot of attention was placed on finding the right balance to get power efficiency with smooth frame rates. Together, we looked at both the latest demanding games and also less graphics intensive games. Our combined focus on automated power management gives you the best performance when the game needs it, but minimizes power when it doesn't. For example, if your game is frame capped at 60 frames per second and the frame renders in 8 milliseconds, then the AMD APU will go into a very low power state for the rest of the 16.7 milliseconds. Going beyond the automated power management, extra knobs are available, allowing developers to manually tune and experiment trade-offs between gaming experience and battery life. Overall, the results exceeded my very high expectations for what we could accomplish by having the Valve and AMD teams work closely together to optimize the handheld PC gaming experience. An aspect of Steam Deck that I have been impressed to see is how developers can leverage not just their Linux applications, but also Windows applications as is, or with minimal changes. This includes supporting all three major APIs on Windows across DirectX, Vulkan, and OpenGL through the Proton translation layer. Of course, games on Windows utilizing the Vulkan API will need fewer software layers through Proton and will make more efficient use of the hardware. With Steam Deck and SteamOS, developers have full access to the open source Mesa graphics driver such as Radeon SI and Radley. AMD has been collaborating with Valve now for many years to improve Linux gaming. Together, we have made significant contribution to the open source Linux driver stack, and we are seeing the fruit of those efforts realized in Steam Deck. Beyond the drivers, there are also multiple software tools available to developers for driver and workload debug and analysis. Those tools include RenderDoc, Radeon Graphics Profiler, GPU Trace Visualizer, and user mode register debugger. These tools and the open source driver stack enable game development to be much more efficient. Developers can debug their crashes and profile their workloads without needing to rely on direct help from Valve or AMD. That being said, both Valve and AMD are actively participating in the open source community, and we are ready to be reachable whenever help is needed. RenderDoc is an API level tool for debugging application that many of you are likely already very familiar with. With RenderDoc, you can capture a frame of an application using a supporting API, including OpenGL, Vulkan, and DirectX, and then use the tool to analyze or edit the state of the API to achieve your desired output. Let me talk to you a little bit about Radeon GPU Profiler, or RGP. RGP is a tool that was originally developed by AMD. This tool is a GUI-based application available in both Linux and Windows that is used for application profiling and tuning. RGP allows PC game developers to have more in-depth access to the GPU and to easily analyze graphics, async compute usage, event timing, pipeline stalls, barriers, bottlenecks, and other performance inefficiencies. RGP was developed based on the Shader Q Thread Trace hardware features, which were added for the consoles and productized on PC graphics as well. Shader Q Thread Trace is a special profiling mode which dumps performance states from the GPU pipeline in hardware and then provides visualization and other information. You can see how much time you've spent in various shader stages on the hardware, and within shaders, you gain more insight into the details of instruction latencies, for example. To generate the traces for RadV and Radeon SI, you will need to set environment variables when you run the application. You also have to tell the kernel driver to enter a polling mode that uses fixed graphics clocks and disables power management to ensure that you get consistent, properly scaled results. Here's an example view of the RGP tool. You can get a bird's eye view of how your command buffers got submitted to each GPU queue and understand how your graphics, async compute, and copy workloads interact and synchronize. With RGP tool, you can understand how your wavefronts were pushed to the GPU. You can also correlate between wavefronts and the GPU events which launched them, and provide insight into how your frame utilizes the various GPU memory caches. The data displayed in this view is highly filterable, groupable, and includes a side panel with added details about user selections. RGP tool can also help you quickly and easily find hotspots in your shaders using the instruction timing view. Each instruction in your RDNA ISA has a bar showing its average latency, allowing you to find the right things to optimize. With RGP tool, you can find out which barriers, flush caches, cause the synchronization point, or even run their own internal shaders. Burst those pipeline bubbles and claim back your performance. Let me talk a little bit about GPU Trace Visualizer, or GPUVis. It is a Linux GPU profiler similar to GPUView on Windows. It's designed to work with trace command captures and help track down Linux GPU and application performance issues. This is a tool useful to visualize trace events generated by the kernel driver and also for analyzing utilization problems to determine if an application is GPU bound or CPU bound. GPUVis lets you see when the work is scheduled on a GPU and when it completes. You can also view things like VBlank events to help understand timing and related problems to your timing. Additionally, you can see when the application are calling driver I/O control codes or I/O controls, or maybe just for checking the status of a buffer. For an example, let's say while checking your application that you observe artifacts, GPUVis may see that you have work scheduled on the GPU happening in parallel on two separate engines rather than sequentially. And that sequentiality was critical to your application. You discover the work between those two engines was not synchronized, and you're adding missing fences or semaphores to address the issue. Here's an example of GPUVis. You can see that the work on graphics and compute are actually running in parallel here. However, the jobs were supposed to run in sequence due to dependency. The compute jobs needed to wait for the result of the graphics, and the application needed to wait for that compute job to finish. After bug being fixed in the application, you can see the jobs are running sequentially. Here's another example. We can use GPUVis to analyze load balancing on CPU and GPU. This example shows a GPU that is fully loaded. And in this one instance, we're showing GPUVis enables you to see that there's probably performance left on the table because there's a gap in the GPU workload. I want to talk for a little bit about UMR, the last tool that we'll talk about today, user mode register debugger for AMD GPUs. It's a command line tool for debugging the GPU driver. UMR communicates directly with the GPU kernel driver to allow you to read registers, check power state information, and telemetry data like temperature and power. And also allows you to check the state maintained by the driver, such as GPU virtual memory page tables. It is useful for debugging kernel and user mode drivers if you are seeing strange behaviors or something like a GPU page fault. I would like to close today. AMD is very excited to be a partner of Valve and Steam Deck. Gamers will be able to play their PC game library on the go and have access to a huge catalog of amazing games, including the latest AAA titles. AMD is committed to delivering the best experiences to gamers across the world on PC, console, and portable devices. Thank you.